Miles' father started breathing softly and was sound asleep. Ava says, What's going on? Matisse says, we have to talk, but let's go outside. I don't want to wake Miles' father up. Yeah, you're right. Miles' father is sleeping quietly. Leave the father up to me. You have stuff to do, don't you? Good luck. Alright, we're gonna talk. Muse says, what's going on? I thought Mile was gone from this world. Yeah, that's what we thought, says Avon. That's what we thought, but... Routee says, Mile's remains were never found. They explain what happened while they were attacked on the Holy Capital Highway. I see, says Muse. Then there was only one answer. Mile was never killed. Never killed, says Avon? Mile is still alive? Marty says, I think that's the logical conclusion. Oh, okay, Mr. Spock. That's kind of amazing, though. But then... was Mile cursed also, and then passed the curse on to him? Because there was something strange about Mile. Marty says, we just don't know the reason for Mile returning to the village by himself or why his father got cursed. Muse says, it's no use to just speculate. We should go to Ourt Village and find out. You're right, says Avon. Avon took out the guardian bell. Avon, says Retis. Let's go to Ourt Village, Avon says. Alright, first we're gonna check with everybody else that we didn't check with. I only have Count Elmar to rely on. I have to get the investigation stopped, but I can do that by having the royal family put pressure on the Grand Cathedral. Alright, I'll leave you to your scheming and mad pontifications. I just talked to him, right? Yeah. I know there's plenty of people I didn't check in on. This is, he was saying it's safe, yeah. To go back in the castle? The man who defied you is still sleeping in at the guild. What does this mean? It means he's asleep. We've been standing guard since then, but we haven't seen anyone suspicious so far, but we'll concentrate on keeping watch. Well, looks like we can check on... in with everyone here as well. Your Highness, isn't your hair a little messy? You didn't enter the cave or fight the monsters or anything like that, did you? What are you talking about, Karen? A wind did this to my hair. Well, that's okay then. You inherited your beautiful black hair with blue tint from your late mother, Queen Uriel. Wouldn't she know that? You are not allowed to leave it uncombed. Not allowed? She's the princess. You should tell her what she's allowed and not allowed to do. She'll whip the life out of you. I heard that the villager who attacked the castle gate was being controlled by someone. The royal family and the Bardas Church prohibit use of any spells that control people's consciousness. Not only can we not use them, but we are also prohibited from studying them. Who in the heck did it then? Someone who doesn't live here. Someone evil. The report says that the unit of General Deeren, headed for Boreas, engaged in battle several times with the Octum's apostles, but enemies are appearing in unexpected places, and at unexpected moments they come in contact with monsters. It will be difficult to get striking results anytime soon. Your Highness, have you seen a book called The 100 Selected Recipes of the Court Dishes? Muse says, unfortunately my specialty is to eat, not to cook. Though my mother was very good at cooking. That's right, she made me dishes several times. If you don't know, then who else? Marty's says, ahaha, I borrowed that book. I've been living here alone for a long time and started to like cooking. Avon says, you too, Marty? I can cook, a little. That's a good attitude, Louise says. These days, men should be able to cook, too. Muse says, well, I feel inferior. You may return that book any time. I just wanted to know who had it. It's okay, says Marty. I will return it in a day or so. It costs a lot of money to cook the recipes in the book. We don't actually have it, do we? Like, I just want to see if it's an... in our inventory. No? Okay. Otherwise, I'd read the thing. I visited Sage Denerkin's mansion several times to receive his teachings. As might be expected from someone called the Sage of Wisdom, all his books are precious ones. I envy a person who has a lot of books. I don't think any of those books would be new. Baron Conrad? They call him Conrad again, instead of Conrad, of Beloa has been pushing his luck recently. He just succeeded the Baron. He is so conceited. Sometime soon I will have to teach him a lesson. My house has a higher status than his. You don't like him succeeding people? Is that what it is? I mean, that's kind of the way things work, and in a kind of royalty or leadership kind of role. Since General Deeren is not in town, the safety of Phildin is up to us. Our responsibility is huge. Huge, I tell you, huge! They say there was a man who summoned the monster in front of the castle gate. On the other hand, I didn't hear that the man was locked up. Could it just be a rumor? About a monster, but yeah, he was not locked up. The lances and armor we are using are mass-produced at the iron factory in Guia. The phrase mass-produced sounds pretty bad, but they are pretty sturdy and good to use. This just means they make a lot of them. Because sometimes quantity will defeat quality. Please don't worry about the monsters, because we are here to protect you. Yeah, they say the same thing. Same stuff. The king will probably have something new to say. Speak. By the way, Mildine, I intend to let you do whatever you want to do. But behave yourself and don't do anything careless. If something happens to you, I wouldn't know what to do. Yes, I understand, says Muse. Yeah, it looks like I can walk back there. This is our room. Ah, Your Highness, you are back. I'm cleaning up your room right now. Thank you for everything, says Muse. Back in. Please wait for a while. New. I guess we'll wait until the room's clean, but we have no need of the room right now. Are these the same people? Okay. Yes, they are. What is that, boy? This is sure a warm and lazy afternoon. So you've heard of the Avon lady? This is the Avon boy. I need to do something stimulating so I don't fall asleep. Marty, do you want to play chess with me? I'm sorry, but I have to accompany Her Highness. So, can I take a rain check? Too bad. I came up with a strategy to finally beat you. Prime Minister Royd and General Deeren are the only people to play for a fair match. I'm so happy that you started the work at the castle, Marty. Okay. Whoops. Get in there. I will never let anyone make trouble in the underground prison in the name of the King's army. Worth a try. I think that's it for the castle. This is the library, right? Do we talk to that guy over there who walking into the bookcase? Yeah, I'll talk to him and her. Alright, or him. Cat found something. Alright, who else do we have to talk to? That girl down there. A woman. Oh. This place really relaxes me. It's got a fountain and it's so refreshing. When I have spare time, I come here. I could see it being relaxing. I checked in with them. Oh. Don't need that. I want to go up. Oh, I have to go up that way. Talk to her. Throwing it away. Yeah, talk to them. This is where we found him last time. Karamuro. No, he's not here. Not last time, but probably the first time ever. It's the inn. Thank you. South is Ourt. What if we try to leave the other way? We don't have time to go to Chibri. We need to find out the truth about what happened at Ourt Village. I just like to see what they say when we hit them. We go the wrong direction. I'm not sure we checked over here, actually. Same thing. My birthday this year is so boring. Dad's not here and Mom's so sad. I don't want a present. I just want my dad to come home. That's sad. I guess this guy is not his dad. I thought it was for some reason. He said that before. I heard that the king's army is not fighting against monsters, but a group of people that use evil spells. I can't believe that my husband is fighting against such people. Avon says, it looks like the general public knows about the Apostles of Darkness. Matisse says, I guess that means they're not to be secretive anymore. Let's head to Ourt Village. We need to find out if Miles really there or not. Yeah, in reality, Avon would be racing towards Ourt Village right away. Can it really be true, though? I think it is. I think it's true, but with a twist. The neighbors are having a big fight again, but they made up quickly. If they continued, I was about to call Marty again. That was close, says Marty. Yeah, you would have a hard time Marty hearing you when we're in Ziziki Cave. Alright, so there's these two. I guess my grandchild is doing well. She seems to have grown up after completing her tasks. I'll need to write back soon. Yeah, she said that before. Okay, I think that's it. I think we talked to everybody. Don't you know what this means? When we get back from Ourt Village, we'll have to talk to them all again. Good God. We can jump down, but we can't get up that way. Alright, let me just throw a save in, because it's been over an hour. Sheep Highway. South is Ourt Village, 415 Milos. We must find out if Mile is alive, indeed. Or if it's some kind of doppelganger. Alright, fine. Attack Mantis while we're attack people. Not a lot of XP. A man's voice yells, "Help!" Adventurer Isaac says, "Oh, you!" Avon says, "Were you attacked by a monster or something?" "No, no. The villagers. It's Ourt Village. Something is wrong. I was attacked." "Huh?" says Avon. Muse says, "You're not making sense. Calm down a little." "Yeah, okay." "Something is wrong with Ourt Village. The villagers suddenly came attacking me." "What?" says Avon. "Can you give us some details?" Marty asks. "I got a job from the guild and went to a tool shop in Ourt to sell some merchandise. When I entered Ourt Village, the villagers were wandering with bloodshot eyes. I felt strange and wanted to know what was going on. But when I spoke to them, they suddenly came attacking me. One by one, they gathered and came after me." Ruti says, "It's the same condition. Miles' father was like that, too." Avon says, "Damn! What's going on? The Ant, Yuzu, and Elder Rowan?" Mew says, "We don't have any more time to waste. We should hurry to Ourt Village. Hey, you, will you report this to the guild?" "Yeah, sure. It's my unlucky day. It was my first job as an adventurer. I also lost the merchandise." "What merchandise?" Marty says, "We've come this far. Let's go a little further to the outskirts of the village. We may be able to see what happened." "All right," says Avon. "I agree. We don't want your low XP fights." Yeah. Oh, the assisting bee is assisting. Missed. How dare you? We're going south, right? No. I deny. To this way? Avon says, "We're close to the entrance of Ourt." Marty says, "What the?" I wonder if there's chests up there, though. Marty says, do you feel it too, Vertes? Yeah, I feel a chillingly evil atmosphere. I don't think it's safe to go in hastily. Muse says, but we can't just stand here and watch. We should fly through in a situation like this. Marty says, Your Highness, please, what will you do if the villagers attack? They're probably innocent people being controlled by someone. We can't hurt them. You have a point, says Muse. Avon asks, so what should we do? I'll go, says Vertes. What? Says Avon. I'll try the hide spell. If it works, I'll go and look around inside the village. Hide spell, Avon says. The one Jimmy was using? Marty says, the spell that uses the refractions of light to make the user invisible? Wow. Vertes, I didn't know you could use such a difficult spell. I've never tried it before. But I saw other people use it, so I know how it works. My spell power has improved since then. I think it's time I try it myself. Wait, says Avon. Can you cast a hide spell on people other than yourself? Yes. It just manipulates the air, so anyone can be the target. Then could you try it on me? I want to see what's happening in Ourt with it my own eyes. Why don't you cast it on all of us? I don't think it's a good idea, says Vertes. I'm faster and more familiar with this kind of work. I should do it myself. I'm sorry, Avon says, but I know every inch of Ourt. I'm a better candidate for this reconnaissance mission. But... Hey, Vertes, says Avon. I tried to forget about Mile, convincing myself he was dead, but I can't give up on him just yet. I want to believe he's still alive. I won't turn away from the truth again. It doesn't matter if he's alive or dead, I just want to know the truth. Please, let me go. Okay. But the hide spell is difficult. You must forgive me if it doesn't work. I understand, says Avon. But I'm sure it will work. You're so strong-willed, says Vertes. Relax your mind. Be your natural self. Here we go. The shining veil of air, dance around with your nimble steps and conceal the visible. Hide. He disappeared, says Muse. I can't believe it. Avon, are you there? Yeah, I haven't moved an inch. It's strange. I can see the things around me, but not my own body. Avon, you should hurry, says Vertes. The hide spell won't last long. All right. I'll go and take a look around the village. You wait here. I can talk to them. Vertes says, I have a bad feeling. I should have gone myself. I hope Avon is not doing anything reckless. So it's not like he's talking to them. He's like eavesdropping. Marty says, Avon, I hope he'll keep his cool in front of Mile. Mew says, all we can do is wait, and I hate waiting. Avon, don't make me wait any longer. Marty says, if you're worried about him, why don't you say so? Now, just in case it does wear out, I'm gonna save. Because I want to look around to see if there's chests. If it'll let me. Wasn't there something over here? I must hurry. The hide spell won't last long, Avon says. Alright. I'm gonna call in an episode here. We'll be entering the village next time. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.